Hello friends, welcome back to channel. Today is 13th September 2020 and in this video we are going to see all the important current affairs from 13th September 2020. Before starting today's video, we will quickly revise the questions asked in our last video. Our first question was, what will be India's GDP growth rate in the current financial year as predicted by UNCTAD? Answer is -5.9%. Recently, Ashrapreet Singh Buller has been banned for 4 years for failing in doping test by NADA. He is associated with which sports? Answer is basketball. Who has been awarded with Gyanpith Award 2019 recently? Answer is Akkitam Achyutam Nambudari. As per the recent report of International Labour Organization, that is ILO, how many people have lost their jobs due to ongoing coronavirus pandemic? Answer is 50 crore. Former cricket player, coach and commentator Dean Jones has died at the age of 59 recently. He was associated with which nation? Answer is Australia. Which of the following day is recently celebrated as World Marine Day? Answer is 24 September. Which of the following day is celebrated as World Pharmacist Day? Answer is 25 September. Eighth question was, SP Bala Subramaniam has recently died at the age of 72. He was a dash. Answer is singer. Ninth question was, which state government has recently launched Moksh Kalash Yojana 2020? Answer is Rajasthan. And last question was, name the person who has become the only Indian actor to be selected in Times 2020 World's Most Powerful Persons. Answer is Ayushman Khurana. These were the questions asked in our last video. Now we will start today's video. Our first question is, which of the following day is celebrated as World Rabies Day annually? Answer is option number 3. 28th September. Every year, 28th September is celebrated as World Rabies Day. Rabies is a viral disease that causes inflammation of the brain in human and other mammals. It is spread when an infected animal bites or scratches a human or other animal's saliva. From an infected animal can also transmit rabies if the saliva comes into contact with the eyes, mouth or nose. And to raise awareness about the impact of rabies and how the disease can be prevented, 20th September is celebrated as World Rabies Day. And theme for 2020's World Rabies Day was End Rabies, Collaborate and Vaccinate. Next, who has recently inaugurated a 4-day festival destination Northeast 2020? Answer is option number 1, Amit Shah. Amit Shah is the Union Home Minister of India, and recently on the occasion of World Tourism Day, which recently has been celebrated on 27th of September, the Union Home Minister Amit Shah has inaugurated the destination Northeast 2020 through video conference. This is a 4-day festival organized from 27th September to 13th September 2020 to promote and showcase the Northeast tourism, culture, heritage and business. And this festival has been organized under the theme The Emerging Delightful Destinations. Answer will be option number 1. Next, which bank has recently launched India's first warehouse commodity finance app? Answer is option number 3, HDFC Bank. Recently, HDFC Bank has launched India's first warehouse commodity finance app. This app will help customers to draw down and manage the loan against the pledge of commodities online without physical intervention or multiple visits to bank. This app will also bring improved efficiencies and time saving for the agri value chain. Answer will be option number 3, HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank, it is an Indian banking and financial services company. It was founded on August 1994. Headquarters is in Mumbai and currently CEO is Shashidhar Jagdishan. Next, which of the following state governments has recently launched Mukhyamantri Kisan Kalyan Yojana? Answer is option number 2, Madhya Pradesh. Recently, the government of Madhya Pradesh has launched Mukhyamantri Kisan Kalyan Yojana. And this scheme has been launched in line with the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme of the central government. Under this scheme, annually rupees 4000 will be transferred to the accounts of around 1,75,000 farmers of Madhya Pradesh in 2 equal installments. Answer will be option number 2, Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh, look it up. This is Madhya Pradesh. Capital is Bhopal. Governor is Anandiben Patel. Chief Minister is Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Its legislature has 230 seats. 29 members are elected to Lok Sabha and 11 members are elected to Rajya Sabha from Madhya Pradesh. It is the second largest by area and fifth largest by population in India. It borders with Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Rajasthan, and Ganga, Godavari, Galti, Narmada and Mahi are the main rivers of Madhya Pradesh. Also, recently, Roko Toko Abhiyan has been started in Madhya Pradesh. 750 megawatt Rewa Ultra Mega Solar Power Project, which is Asia's largest solar power project, has been started in Madhya Pradesh. Intezar Aapka, a social media campaign, has been started by Madhya Pradesh. Hamara Ghar Hamara Vidyalay campaign, Kill Corona campaign, Ek Mask Anek Jindagi campaign has been started by Madhya Pradesh. Indore has become the cleanest city in India in Swachh Sarvekshan 2020. And also, Madhya Pradesh is the best performing state in India in implementation of PM Swanidhi scheme. Next, who has been appointed as the new Chief Secretary of West Bengal recently? Answer is option number 1, Alapan Bandopadhyay. Alapan Bandopadhyay is a 1987 batch IAS officer, and recently he has been appointed as the new Chief Secretary of West Bengal. He will take charge from October 1st, 2020, and he will succeed Rajiv Sinha, who will retire on September 13th. Answer will be option number 1. Stephanie Taylor has recently become the only second cricketer to score 3,000 runs in international T20 cricket. She is associated with Dash. Answer is option number 1, West Indies. Look into the image. This is Stephanie Taylor, captain of West Indies women's cricket team. And recently, he has become the only second cricketer to score 3 runs in international T20 cricket. First is Suji Bates. Answer will be option number 1. Next, who is the author of the book titled Reset, Regaining India's Economic Legacy? Answer is option number 4, Subramaniam Swamy. Look into the image. This is Subramaniam Swamy. He is an Indian politician, economist and statistician who serves as the nominated member of parliament in Rajya Sabha. And recently, the book called Reset, Regaining India's Economic Legacy has been written by Subramaniam Swamy. In this book, he has described 150 years of India's economic journey. Also, he has provided some radical measures to enable growth like abolishing income tax. Answer will be option number 4. Next, Gurpreet Singh Sandhu is associated with which sports? Answer is option number 4, football. Look into the image. This is Gurpreet Singh Sandhu. He is an Indian professional football player and a goalkeeper. He was awarded with Arjun Award in 2019, and recently he has been awarded by Men's Footballer of the Year by All India Football Federation. Answer will be option number 4, football. Next, how many scientists have been awarded by Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize 2020? Answer is option number 2, 14. Recently, 14 scientists have been awarded by Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize 2020. Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize, also called Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize for Science and Technology, is a science award in India given annually by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that is CSIR, for notable and outstanding research. It was named after the founder and director of the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar. It was first awarded in 1958, and now in 2020, it has been awarded to 14 scientists. Answer will be option number 2. Next, what will be India's GDP growth rate in the financial year 2020-21 as predicted by NCAER? Answer is option number 4, minus 12.6%. Recently, NCAER, that is National Council of Applied Economic Research, it is a Delhi-based non-profit think tank of economic. It was established in 1956 with financial support from the Ford Foundation, Finance Ministry and Tata Sons. And the president of NCAER is Nandan Nilkani. And recently, NCAER has predicted India's GDP growth rate for the current financial year as minus 12.6%. Answer will be option number 4. Now, answer of the question which was asked in last video. Question was, who is the author of the book titled Our Only Home, A Climate Appeal to the World? Answer is option number 1, Dalai Lama. Dalai Lama is the author of book titled Our Only Home, A Climate Appeal to the World. Now, today's question. Question is, which state government has launched My Family, My Responsibility campaign to combat COVID-19? Options are Gujarat, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Karnataka. If you know answer of this question, you can write it in the comment section below, or we will discuss this question in the next video.